Being able to work on something that actually goes and flies in space as an undergraduate student is something I never thought I would be able to do, and that's a fantastic experience.
It's the first satellite, the first spacecraft to be built and tested from West Virginia. We got students to bring cutting-edge science that we could then integrate, and we had to work with them hand in hand.
Working with NASA definitely gave me some more insights into how things need to happen in the real world and looking at the bigger picture, and now I'm in graduate school. That's definitely been a benefit to me.
It was a chance to work with actual space flight hardware and work on an actual spacecraft, so that was very rewarding for me.
It's gratifying that students got an opportunity to participate in this, and I would say it's not my hard work, it's a lot of the students' hard work. There's a lot of heavy lifters on this program. We had a great partnership with NASA IV&V. There are two other experiments at Wvu, and it'll be a joy to see all of this come together and have West Virginia finally get into space.
It feels pretty good knowing that something I've worked on and still working on is going to space, and the work I've been doing for the past 2 years, we'll have a chance to actually test some of the methodology once it launches. I never expected to work on something like that as an undergrad.
My favorite part of working on this was knowing that I was working on something that was actually going to fly in space and on West Virginia's first spacecraft, nonetheless.
I think it'll be extremely gratifying to see, because how many people really get to say, hey, I sent something into space?
When STF-1 finally launches and I get to see the data actually coming back down from orbit with my software, I will be very relieved and very happy.
It'll be relief because we've been waiting so long.
A major relief.
I guess the key word here would be relieved, right?
Not really a sense of relief, but it'll be really awesome to watch.
This is a big achievement to have a spacecraft that's completely built and flown by different folks in the state of West Virginia. And it really opens up doors to do more exciting experiments in the future.